Hey everyone, it's me, Wendy. There have been quite a few new subscribers lately. Hello! As well as comments related to sewing resolutions. So I wanted to make this video to go through some motivational tips to get your sewing corner organized and ready to go. We'll get right into 5 tips, and at the end I'll also share some of my sewing supplies because I know it can be a bit overwhelming to figure out where to start, what you need, all that kind of stuff. Do not forget to subscribe if you want to see more sewing videos from me, and I'll see you at the end. Number 1, when you're picking where you want your sewing studio to be, try to do what you can to put it near a designated open floor space. Realistically, you're going to be cutting and doing all that stuff on the floor. The other thing that really helps out with productivity and feeling good is to have a mirror nearby as well, especially when you're making your own clothes. You want to be able to just throw it on, see how it looks in the mirror, get right back into sewing. At my parents' place, the sewing setup that they had no mirror, and I would just like throw stuff on, run around in the basement to the bathroom, look in the bathroom. By the time I came back, I might have even forgotten what the heck I was going over there for. So put that open floor space, that mirror nearby, and that'll be a good spot for your sewing studio to start. Number 3 is that you definitely need to keep your tools within arm's reach. Like, your bum should not move from the chair when you want to grab your items, if possible. The way I do this is I have a pegboard, which you can see behind me. Even when I was renting, I did use a pegboard because this one, it can just be held up with 2 nails, equivalent of picture hanging nails. So that was permitted at the condo that I lived at before. I have a wide variety of hooks that I've gotten for my pegboard. At the top, all of these hooks hold up my scissors, and underneath that there's something new, which is these smaller hooks I got that are a perfect fit for bobbins. I'm totally crazy about this section, so this was a really, really nice addition. Another thing I've really loved were these wire baskets from the dollar store. I hung them on using hooks, and these baskets help to hold all the stuff that I use often but doesn't have something that's easily hookable to the pegboard. Down at the bottom, I took these long hooks and these small binder clips, and I've created a little shoppable section of some zippers, elastics, and some thread. I just really love the way thread looks when it's all nice and neat. So that's how I've put everything on this pegboard. But if you can't mount a pegboard, another option is to do it in some shelving that is really close to your table. Within each of these openings, I have more containers that organize different things. And yeah, this whole time the bum has stayed in the chair. If you can't have a pegboard, nor can you have shelving nearby, I have a drawer right here underneath the table. So it's out of sight when you see me like this. It's out of sight when I shoot from above to show my workspace. Whatever I'm using while I'm sewing, it all gets thrown in here, and then the moment I want my sewing space to look clean, just slide the drawer out of sight, and it's all good. So that is my 4th tip, is use a drawer. Just keep that top drawer empty as a means to make sure that your table space always stays nice and neat. Now that you have the floor space, a mirror to see yourself, things to keep your tools all within arm's reach, the last thing you can really do for yourself is to set up a good mood, treat yourself. You're trying to be creative, you're trying to form something out of a piece of fabric. I asked on Instagram if anyone had any requests for things to help them organize their space, and one of the top things that came up dealt with scraps and how to deal with them. I have put up a video in the past about that, so I will put a link in the description. I organize them based on what season they came from. My theory, and it's worked well for me, is that I find more often or not you're looking for a piece of fabric because of its like material and warmth and thickness than I am looking for a piece of fabric for its color. So that's how I do my scraps. I have these solid colored fabric baskets here, and these ones I keep a whole bunch of scraps in. They're out of sight, but they are really close by. Other things that can contribute to the mood is lighting. So I have these two lights up above me, as well as a ring light up here in front. With these two lights, they used to always be pure white daylight light bulbs, which looks really great for filming, but is very sad to work in for a long period of time. So what we've done is we've installed these smart hue changing light bulbs. I'm not sponsored by them, I'd love to be. So with these studio lights, right now they are on a setting that I've titled ring light. I can also turn them more yellow, it's like a good reading light. This is icy. Yeah, not good for work. And I can make them pink as well. So that's something else that I really recommend, not necessarily getting smart light bulbs, but some means to have the lighting be bright, but also warm and inviting when you just want to relax. You can also think about your decor. As you can see, I'm a little bit lacking in the decor department, and that's just because we're still kind of new to our condo, but when it comes to organization, at the very least, I always am willing to invest in organization that pretty much doubles as decor. And lastly, you can think even about the air. I've been really into my air diffuser lately. I just kind of keep it right over there out of sight. I'm pretty sure it's like literally just out of the bounds of the camera when it's shooting, but I'll put in a variety of scents and it just kind of like fills the air and makes me feel like I'm in a creating mood. Those were really quickly my five tips, and now I just wanted to talk about some sewing supplies like I promised. Thankfully, none of these things end up ever being super, super expensive, at least the small tools, but to help you with getting started with that, I finally put together a really nice and shoppable list of different supplies that I recommend when you're starting out on sewing. I did try really hard to pick the things that were the best intersection of quality and price tag. I've also in the past gone over some sewing hacks for your sewing space. I've gone over how I set up my camera and lights. I'll put the link in the description for you and you can go check those out too. If you have any other sewing organization tips or hacks, please do let me know in the comments. I'm going to look through and pick out some of my favorites and put them together in Instagram posts because it's really nice to share this kind of stuff. I want people to be able to create things that they didn't even think they could create. Like, honestly, I don't even know if a lot of times I thought I could create a finished garment out of a piece of fabric, but it happens and people send me photos of them doing it, so it feels good, and I want you guys to keep doing that because, I don't know, it's like empowering to make your own stuff. That'll be it for today. Thank you all so much for watching. If you did subscribe, then I'll see you next time. Bye. This video is made possible by my Patreon supporters. If you'd like to support me as well, go to patreon.com/withwendy.